Hey, how we doing? Today is the 17th of April, if you're just viewing this in a few weeks' time. And as of this date, this is my top 10 valuable pops according to the pop directory. Now, the reason I put in the date is because it can vary really fast, it changes a lot. And anyone that can count is maybe thinking, well, that's not 10 pops, mate. You're right, it's not, it's 11, because two of them are the exact same value. So that allowed me to squeeze in number 11, or number 10 as I'm calling it today. So one of my friends suggested making shorter videos, so let's try that. Let's try the flash. Horrible. Yeah, we can't even. So, let's do it in reverse order. Superman, Man of Steel, my favourite comic movie ever. My favourite Superman ever. I'm 40 years old. I did grow up watching Christopher Reeve, but at the same time, he's my Superman. So yeah, got him for about 25. I never got him from the shop, I got him from eBay, but it was a good while ago. And £25 now seems not too bad. Freddy Funko's Carnage, I paid exactly, I think it's lost about £12 of value, but I needed it. There is a Blacklight one as well, but that's not. But yeah, he's cool, he's really cool. This one, I got in at the start, so probably paid £10 or something from one of the shops. So he goes up and down. When the last Spider-Man film had the three of them in it, it was going up and down mad because obviously Andrew Garfield was back. One of the chase pops I got in a lot from a guy, so I believe she would have been roughly £20, you know, at the time, because I think it was like 500 or something, and she's worth more than that now, and she goes up and down as well. She definitely jumps up and down in my value. M&M, B-Rabbit, I picked up two for cost price from Pop in the Box, and I gifted one to my best friend right at the start, and they've went up really well, so I'm happy that he's got one, and I'm happy I've got one. So yeah. Eradicator, I'm obsessed with Superman. I know I've not done a Superman collection, there's a reason for that. I've got a lot of Superman stuff, but I wouldn't say I overpaid for that. I would just say it's not held the value I thought it would. So he might be number 6, so to speak, or 5, depending on what way you look at it. But yeah, he's dropped in value considerably, but I'm still, I love it. I really, really like it. This is holding at the exact same I paid for it. I paid 89 and he's still 89. I got into a bidding war with somebody when it first came out on eBay, and I was just, when I say determined to get it, I was determined to get it and I got it. Now I'm going to try and get the Joker, but I can't afford it. He's quite pricey, the Joker, I believe. So yeah, I'll get it one day, but I mainly collect Batman, Superman, Boba Fett pops and Spider-Man pops, so that's my sort of four go-to. This came from a friend, he offered me it. I think he, believe it or not, got it at a car boot sale. It's got a wee dent here, and he offered me it. And I'll tell you a quick story, the same person that also offered me Rorschach and Dr. Manhattan loose, and I said no, because I'm a genius. I wish I took them. But luckily I did take this guy, and for what I paid for him, I'm really happy to still have him. And then we're moving up to the NFTs, holding top 3 spots, no shock there. These all came from the same person. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh no, it's a lie. These came from the same person. Did they? No, they all came from the same person. Yeah, sorry, I'm arguing myself here, as you do. Yeah, he was the first, and that's what made the introduction to somebody who's now a great friend of mine. This bad boy, and this bad boy was a bundle deal, and they've actually just about what I paid for them, so it's really like for like, so I'm happy, person's happy. So yeah, really cool. I want to get into the advertising pieces. I've got some of the Coca-Cola ones and stuff, so I'd really like to have a lot of them. This is a really great animated movie if you've never seen it. It's called Gotham by Gaslight. It's really good, really, really good. And number one is Freddy Funko's Batman. I'd love a few more of the Freddys, but they're pricey. In previous videos, I've done really silly things, like I've not put this one in my Spider-Man collection. And, you know, little things like that. But I just don't think at the time. I really don't. So, yeah. So this is a quick look. Just pause if you want to see any and look them up. And the reason I'm not told you the value of everything is I'm just not like that. This is not a flex. I've got people I know that would put my collection to shame. But I don't just collect pops. If I did just collect pops, I think I'd have a fierce collection. But I collect everything. And times are tight. I live in the UK. I'm not working at the moment. So that's why you don't see anything new in my collection. It's I do this to combat my mental health. And let me quickly tell you what I got meant to do on YouTube and TikTok is I used to love watching people's collection videos, and eventually I thought, well, hold on, if I'm watching people's action figures and statues and stuff, why not share? Because if they never shared, I'd have had nothing to watch. So this is really just about me joining that community and being part of it. So that's exactly why I do it. It's not for a flex, it's not for a pat on the back, it's not to get followers, it's just genuinely to be part of this community because I love it. And I don't just collect this, it's Hot Wheels, statues, comics, and more. So, yeah, 5 minutes of me non-stop talking. If you don't know what the Pop Directory is, it's an app for valuing your pops. Most people use it, but apparently eBay sold listings is the way to go for accurate value because sometimes the Pop Directory can vary. I've got items like this guy who's not been sold for about 500 days on it. So always check eBay sold listings as well, okay? Take care, thanks for watching, and cheers.